Hello, planet Earth. Welcome to my YouTube channel. We're at IDK, my BFF Jill 730.
BFF Jill 730.
I'm Preston L. Young, wishing you warm salutations and congratulations as always. You've made your way to the Buffington Post.
You are invited.
So this week we got two new issues of the Buffyverse comics, and yesterday I went over Buffy the Vampire Slayer season 11 issue number 4, which was good because Buffy's been good all through season 11. And so today we're going to talk about Angel season 11 issue number 2. It's Out of the Past part 2. But before we get into it, previously on Angel.
Angel and Fred went to Ireland to investigate this like poltergeist haunting situation at a friend's hotel. However, they found out that because of something in Angel's past, for some reason there's like this breach in reality where like these bugs and these like flower monsters are coming in from maybe an alternate dimension? And it all has to do with something that Angel did in his past, and so at the end of the issue, Illyria like swept Angel through time, and that's what's going on. And that's pretty much what you need to know. Fate's not around, Ko's not around, Nadira's not around, Gunn and Connor are still not around, and yeah.
So let's get into Angel and Illyria cruising through time. Part 2. Oh, I mean, Angel, season 11, issue number 2. It's Out of the Past, part 2. Here we go.
I'll even be dull, boring.
At the dawn of the last century, a band of explorers searched for a prehistoric world. Driven by ambition, secret desires, a thirst for adventure. And seeking the ultimate story, they are befriended by an untamed beauty. Stranded in a strange and savage land, each day is a desperate search for a way out of the lost world.
So the issue opens up, and of course, we pick up where we left off with Illyria opening a portal through time, and Angel's like kind of freaking out, like, where are we? But of course, Illyria makes a super, like, timely Lost joke and says, don't you mean, when are we? So basically, we're in this like tropical friggin' wonderland, and Illyria kind of recognizes where they are, but Angel has no clue, and Illyria admits to the fact that she accidentally, like, didn't send them to the right place in time, and then all of a sudden, Fred comes about. So it's daytime, where and whenever they are, and so Angel is hiding out in the shadows while Fred climbs this like mountain situation to go and see what exactly the what and when and where is. Well, wherever and whenever they are, there are these like demons just walking around, and it looks like demons rule the earth, so clearly we're very much in the past. Doesn't explain a whole lot, but Fred gets the impression that Illyria has some kind of like sentimentality with whatever and whenever and wherever they are. So Angel and Fred don't really know what exactly is going on, but then it turns out that whoop-de-doo, there they are, and they are in the kingdom of Illyria in its original form, because hello, there it is, way back in the oldest of the days. Confusion abounds, and Angel is saying, well, since the Illyria that's all up in you right now, Fred, isn't willing to help us out, maybe we can get this, like, other Illyria to help us out. And then, whoop-de-doo, Illyria comes about and says, you think they're just fucking with you when they call me the Merciless? Like, no, they mean it. Like, I'm not a nice person, especially not back then. So clearly, whatever and whenever and where the heck ever they are has more to do with Illyria and Illyria's problems than with Angel and Fred. And they notice that like all of these demons are like running out of the woods because, hello, here comes Illyria to like eat them. But it turns out the reason that the demons are all like running out of the woods isn't because of Illyria itself, but rather this other force that Illyria is about to tell us all about. So the reason that they're in this like whacked timeline is because basically Illyria was thinking about Angel's past to try and get them there, but then she inadvertently started thinking about her own past and her own regrets. Her. And whoop-dee-doo, like, there was this whole, like, situation that happened where this demon came and basically had a turf war with Illyria, and Illyria, being, like, God Supreme Old One Demon guy, was like, fuck it, if I can't have, like, my subjects and my slaves and my land, then I'll just burn it all to the ground with this demon so nobody can have it. And basically, we're supposed to believe that Illyria feels bad about this. So basically, Illyria wants to, like, stop this other old one that, you know, made Illyria massacre all of its subjects and land. But Illyria, in its current, like, humanish form, is really no match for this old one any more than it was back in the day, because they were both kind of, like, evenly matched. And we have all this stuff with, like, Illyria and Fred going back and forth, and then whoop-dee-doo, they come upon this, like, demon guy who, like, used to live in the village that's no longer there because of all the destruction that's going on with this extra. So this demon guy does not trust Angel and Fred because they appear to be very much human, and they assure him that they are very much not human. And so, like, whatever, all of this is going to be caused by Illyria's subjects, the ones who fear and love and worship it. They're all going to try and, like, fight for Illyria's honor, and that's what's going to cause, like, most of the death and carnage. And so, basically, Angel and Fred claim to be prophets from the future, and they're trying to convince this demon guy to not only himself, but everyone, not stand up and fight against this other old one that's going to have this turf war with Illyria. And then OG Illyria shows up. And naturally, everybody's freaking the fuck out. And that's where we end the issue. Angel and Illyria, cruising through time with weird storylines that have nothing to do with fucking anything. What are we doing? I don't know what we're supposed to be doing. I don't know what I'm supposed to be getting out of this book. I don't know what the fuck this is supposed to be. I don't know. I was all upset, you know, when I found out that Faith wasn't gonna be in this new Angel series at the end of the summer. I was like, oh no, freaking out. I am so glad that Faith is not involved with this bullshit. I just don't get it. I really don't understand what we're trying to accomplish. Like, what's the point of time travel? If time is, like, all cyclical and it's all just kind of, like, there, then that would mean that the reason that Illyria, like, got into this battle with the old one from, like, the past was because Angel and Fred would have muddled with time in the first place. Like, it always happens this way. Is that not how fucking time travel works? This is the only issue of the Buffyverse comics that I could find yesterday, and I technically kind of had to steal it from someone because basically somebody doesn't pick up their Angel pre-orders, and since nobody else in town had it, they were like, sure, we'll let you have this guy's. And so, at first I felt kind of bad, but I'm glad I'm sparing the dude, because, hello, this is bad. We do have a few moments between Angel and Illyria that are really funny, and we have a few moments between Fred and Angel that are passably funny. And I like the kind of switching back and forth that we see between Illyria and Fred, and I guess it's interesting, the idea that Illyria is kind of, like, growing a conscience and having, like, bad feelings about her past massacres. But again, time travel. So let's say Illyria didn't do this whole, like, massacre on, like, its whole, like, subjects and land and the other old one just to, like, prove a point. Like, what does that mean? Let's say she doesn't do that, and then what? We're gonna completely change history? Like, that's the thing. Like, time travel is kinda dumb, Angel. I don't know what we're trying to accomplish here. I get that there's this whole, like, situation with, like, reality coming undone with the bugs escaping from whatever the heck or wherever the heck, and then the, like, flower monster thing coming from wherever and whatever the heck, but why are we doing this? It doesn't make any sense. Like, do you care about Illyria's, like, super long ago past? Because I don't. I like Illyria, but the fun with Illyria is the fact that Illyria doesn't get to dwell on the past. Illyria dwelling on the past is what it did, like, all the way in season 5 when it was actually there for like the 6 or 7 episodes that it's there. There's only so much you can do with it, and that's what I like about the Illyria character. It's about you can't live in the past anymore. You have to be in today. And sure, today, they're in the past, but why? Again, we've got so much wonderful stuff going on in Buffy season 11, and this is just a way for Angel and Illyria to just go cruising through time, avoiding the whole, like, magical registration bullshit. There are no stakes. There are no real stakes in time travel stories because we know that Angel and Illyria are gonna come back and they're gonna, like, fix Angel's what the heck ever. And like I said last month, and I really have a problem with the fact that we have 2 months in a row of what I would say don't pick up. And this is really a labor of love for you guys. Like, this is a labor of love. Like, here I am, like, rocking it out with the Buffyverse trying to inform you on what you ought not buy. And I can't say with any good conscience that you should buy this, because it's pointless. It means nothing. It may as well be the IDW comics that are not Angel After the Fall. You know what I mean? I'm so frustrated. I don't understand the reasoning. Why are we doing this? My thing is, why should I care about anything going on here when I feel like it doesn't matter? Like, right? It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter to me. I don't care what Illyria did way back on, like, the third day of reality. I really don't. And I honestly cannot believe, like, you guys were saying in Angel and Faith season 10, like, oh, I don't like it. I don't like it. And I was like, oh, no. Just stick with it. Stick with it. I can't tell anybody to stick with this. And of course, I'm going to have to because it's my unpaid job to get in front of this damn camera and tell you, like, what the heck's going on. But this, I don't know. It's got, like, 2 more issues to get good, and then even I might jump ship, because this is just not what I want. And like I said, I'm glad Faith isn't here for this bullshit that doesn't mean or matter to anything. Like I said, we get some interesting stuff with, like, Illyria and Fred, and the kind of back and forth, and, like, Fred trying to, like, decipher Illyria's emotions and memories, and it's pseudo-interesting, but for the most part, I don't give half a holy hot one about anything that's going on here, and I don't know why I should, because time travel. I mean, I'm all about some, like, time travel shows, and I'm all about some time travel this and that, but I don't need Angel and Illyria to be cruising through time for me to enjoy them. Like, again, what's the point of this? No. I really have nothing else to say about this issue. I just can't get on board. I mean, I'm on board since technically I'm giving my money to this shit, but I cannot in good conscience recommend that you do. I guess if you just like the idea that it's Angel and Illyria doing all of this, running through time and stuff and, you know, having the history that they have, good for you. Like, maybe you'll like it, but I mean, you could replace Angel and Illyria with 2 other people and call it something completely else, and I would believe that it's not Angel Season 11, because it has nothing to do with anything that I can decipher. That's it, Planet Earth. Like, what did you think of this shit show that they're calling Angel Season 11 number 2? I'm just not bad about it. I don't care. Do you? I kind of doubt it, but, I mean, you get your own opinion. Unless Illyria and Angel go back in time to, like, take your opinion and its weight away, which, hey, they might do, but, like, again, it goes back to, like, time travel. What's the point? Because it's, you think they're not gonna end up back where they started? Come on now. The end, I really don't have anything else to say. I'm Personnel Young. You can come right back to the Buffington Post anytime for Buffy the Vampire Slayer reviews, Angel and Illyria cruising through time reviews, Buffyverse discussions, discussions on the other Slayers, and more. Have yourself a great day today. Recoup from this, and we'll see you next time. Bye. Nothing even matters. Nothing even matters at all. Nothing even matters. Nothing
These matters buildings could drift out to sea. Some natural catastrophe. Still there's no place. place I'd rather be. Cause nothing even matters to me. See, nothing even matters. See, nothing even matters to me. Nothing even matters.
My
D.
Okay. My
B.
F. F.
Joe.
730.
But before we get into it, previously on Angel. Angel and Fred went to Ireland to investigate this, like, poltergeist haunting situation at a friend's hotel,